Right guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video. In this one I'm just going to be showing you how to change the wheel bearings in your DT Swiss X1900 mountain bike wheel, that's a rear wheel. So I'll go ahead, I'll run through the steps. Right, so here we have the rear wheel, as you can see. Now, what you want to do is you've got to remove your free head body. So if you've regularly serviced the wheel before, or the free head body, you should just be able to get hold of it and pop it off, but that's not normally the case. Normally the end cap there is holding it on so you can't pull it off. So you've either got to put the wheel in a vise, like so, then with some soft jaws just clamp onto the end cap, and then using the wheel pull up and it should pop off. Or the other way you can do it is, if you've got a cassette on there already, just loosen the lock ring off slightly so you know you can undo it by hand, and then with the cassette on there just put your hands behind the cassette and lever up with your hands and it should pop the end cap off. So that's one way of doing it, and then you're left with the freer body inside the cassette. But that's not a problem because obviously you're after doing the wheel bearings. So I might be able to pull this one off like so. It's been off before, so it'll come off. Then you've got the end cap like so. Then you can just pull off the actual freer body like so. And then just inside there, you just remove the spacer collar that's in there. Put that to one side for cleaning. That's the spacer. And you can see the bearing in the end there. So that's the drive side. So it's the same with the non-drive side, the disc side. So if you haven't had it off before, you need to remove the end cap like so. Obviously you can clamp it in a vise again and then pull up on the wheel to remove it. If you have to with this side, obviously there's no way of getting it off without doing that. So clamp in the vise and then pull up on it to remove that. Right, so next step is, obviously I've got a block of wood on the floor, as you can see, on hard surface. We need to knock out the bearing from the drive side out the non-drive side, so we get rid of the non-drive side bearing, the disc side, up in there. As you can see, it's flush, the shaft sticking out through the middle of the axle, and it's flush there on the end, so you can't just put that on a block of wood and hit it, because the axle it's not going to come out through. So what you want to do is just get yourself a block of wood is the best thing, because it saves damaging your area where the disc is going to go. So what I've got is a block of wood there, as you can see, and it's got a hole drilled in it so the shaft can go down through and the bearing can start to come out enough. So I'll just rest that disc side down over the hole like so. And then what you want to do is hit the shaft here where the freer body was. Don't hit it with a normal hammer. Obviously it's aluminium, so you'll damage it completely and it'll be worthless then. You won't be able to reuse it, you have to buy another one. So get yourself a mallet, rubber mallet, or soft blow hammer to hit that with. So I'll go ahead, I'll hit that through. And as you can see, there's the bearing, just there, on the shaft, the axle. So all I do now, so I can pull that through, out with the axle like so. And that's the non-drive side bearing. Right, so now we've removed the disc side bearing, we can remove the free hub side, which is up in there. Now there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can get the shaft that just came out like so, and then it came out like this through this way. So you can just turn it back round, put that down through there, and sit it in the middle of the bearing, and then hit down on that, knock it out that way. Again, just putting it on your block of wood. Now, personally, I don't bother doing that, just in case you damage in any way the axle, because if you damage that, then they're not cheap to replace. So, and you got the hassle of finding one. So the best thing to do is, all I do is put your wheel down again like so, and I'll just get an 18 millimeter socket like so, with a 3/8 socket, 3/8 drive, and then that go straight down the middle of the hub and rest on the bearing, and then this is much, take a lot more impact than that aluminium shaft, the axle would, so it's easier to do it like this, and it doesn't matter about that so much as it does your axle, because if you ruin your axle, then your wheels, you won't be riding again till you get a replacement. So I'll go ahead, we'll hit that down and out that way. As you can see, it's nearly out now, so what you have to do is obviously hold it up off your block of wood, otherwise you won't be able to hit it out to the last bit. So you just hold it up, just keep it up like so, then just tap it out like so. There you have the bearing there. So what you can do now is go ahead and clean up where the bearings were sitting inside the hub. Give them a wipe round, get any old dirt and grease out of there. Then we're ready to go ahead and reinstall new bearings. Right, so once you've got the hub cleaned out where the bearings are going to sit, make sure it's thoroughly cleaned up. Then you cleaned off the shaft of any old grease and anything. What you want is two new bearings, like these. And you only want to use top quality bearings, no cheap ones, because they don't last 5 minutes, so it's a waste of time doing it. So you always use good quality bearings. And these are 6902 bearings, so there's two of them, 6902 RS. So what you want to do first of all is get some grease, put around where the bearing's going to sit, inside there. Just smear some in there, like so. Then we'll be knocking, see, this is the drive side where the freer body was. So we'll put this one in first. And then what you want to do is get your bearing, like so. Just put some grease around there, outside of the bearing. Just help it. And then whichever side's going to be down inside the wheel, side that you're not going to see, I'll just put some grease over the back edge of it, or the back side of it as well. Just paint some over there, because it just helps keep any water out of the bearing that gets in the inside the hub. So you just put a load over the back of it like so, like that. And then you can just get that. If you want it easier, you can just stick it on your finger there and just lower it in. Put it on there like so. And make sure that it's square. It's not going in at an angle or anything. So don't start hitting in when it's crooked. You got to get it square on there before you start hitting in. And then to put it in, get yourself a socket. It's a 20mm socket. So it's the same as the outside edge of the bearing. So you don't ever hit where the seal is on a good bearing. You can hit the old ones out where the seal is, it doesn't matter about that. Just don't hit where the seal is on any bearings when they're new, otherwise you'll damage them straight away. So you want to hit on the outside edge, so it's exactly the same size like so. So you just rest that on there. Then you can tap it in. Just make sure it's going in square all the time. It's not going in it's not going in crooked. Just keep your eye on that. Right,
Right, so you see the new bearing all the way in, installed there. So what you do now, turn your wheel facing down the bearing you just put in, like so. And then what you want to do is shaft like so. Do is just grease, this is where the free hub would go on, this end, the long end, just grease there where the bearing is you've just put in, like so, and then grease this end there where the bearing's going to sit for the disc side, and then put the shaft back down through and through the bearing you just installed to put it in place, like so. And then, as you can see, the shaft's going to be sticking out like that, so it's no good resting it on the block of wood now to hit, put the new bearing in this side, the disc side. So you want two blocks of wood next to each other so you can, so the shaft's not hitting the floor, so keep them up off the ground. So I'll put another block of wood down. Right, so I've got another block of wood, see, the same size as the other one, so you can just put that next to it like so, then you can rest that on there just like that. Now I've got a vise, so I don't have to do it like this, but this is an option. If you haven't got a vise, this is a way to do it. If you've got a vise, that's just acting as a vise basically, just keeping it up, so you can just open your vise up with some soft jaw, so it's not going to damage the hub at all. Just make sure you don't damage anything. But this is just showing you that you can do it on the floor. You don't need any special tools to do this with. Just a couple of blocks of wood, sockets, hammer, some grease. So what I'll do, I'll go ahead, put some grease down in there where the bearing's going to sit, like so, just help it go in. Then again, I'll put some grease around the outside of the bearing, like so, and then whichever side's going to be inside the wheel, I'll just put some grease over the seal at the back, because water is what kills all these bearings. So you want to try and keep it out if you can. Once you've done that, go ahead and push your bearing down in as far as it'll go until it stops by hand, like so. And then again, using your socket, it'll just drop straight in there, exactly the same size as the bearing, the outer. And then go ahead and tap that down in until it stops. There you go, there's the disc side bearing installed. So what you want to do is make sure that your shaft turns okay, like so. Right, so we've got the bearings installed, it's time to put the free hub back on. So what you want to do is make sure that you grease the shaft that's coming out the free hub side thoroughly. And then what you want to do is your spacer collar there, came off, put that all the way down so it touches the bearing, and then see, then you get your free hub again. Now what you want to do is wipe any old grease off and then re-grease the pulls on it as well, sticking out. Make sure they're all working properly before you go ahead and put that back on. Slide that back in, like so. And then put your end cap on. Don't forget to put some grease up inside the end cap and over the end of it there, because there's no ring there that holds it on to the shaft sticking out. Just grease that up in there. And then you can pop your O-ring, your end cap back in, like so. then just spin it round to this side. Do the same again, put some grease on your end cap. So just put some grease up inside there, just over the face of there, like so. And then you can pop that back on, like so. And that's the bearings reinstalled and everything reinfitted. So you go ahead, put the cassette back on if you'd removed it, and then refit it back in your bike. Right, so there's the steps complete for you. So if you found the video helpful, remember to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel for more cycle related content. Till next one, ride safe, and I'll see you then.